Hey guys, welcome back to Haven. We'll be going on to the Storm Coast again, don't worry. I'm not completely leaving it already. It's just, I wanted to go ahead and say hi to our new friends, Krem and Ironbull, now that they're here. Especially since, frankly, I'm sad to say it, but despite Ironbull being known as being like one of the coolest characters in this game, I already made a two-handed weapon warrior Qunari, so unless there's a part where I get to control him separately, which will probably never happen because they'll probably always have me playing as Vasti to some extent, it's hard to find a reason to bring Iron Bull into the fray if he's just a duplicate of my main character, because I can't exactly remove my main character from the party. So we might as well talk to him in town if he's not going to be adventuring with us.
They've got good form. Cullen's putting his Templar training to good use.
Did Cullen tell you he was a Templar? He's not wearing the armor.
He didn't have to. Might not be a Templar shield, but it's a Templar holding it. He angles the shield just a bit down. Helps direct fire or acid away, so it doesn't spray right into your face. Qunari learned the same thing when we trained to fight Tevinter mages. Your Templar's doing good work.
I'm impressed by what Cullen has accomplished with the troops.
Damn right. It takes time to build a group into a team, but he's got their loyalty. Now he just needs them to make a decent shield wall, and they'll be good to go. Biggest problem for the Inquisition right now isn't on the front line. It's at the top. You've got no leader. No Inquisitor.
Ooh, the toss-up between Leliana and Cassandra. It's hard to say. Cassandra knows the truth, but Leliana is more or less the... They're both parts of the Chantry. They're both religious, so I can't say one of them's more into that. But Leliana is kind of the one making more decisions, I'd say. I'm not going to claim that I lead, because Lord knows I don't know what I'm talking about.
Leliana's been pulling the strings of the Inquisition ever since it started.
Red's your spymaster, not your leader. I don't see her standing in the spotlight anytime soon. My people don't pick leaders from the strongest, or the smartest, or even the most talented. We pick the ones willing to make the hard decisions, and live with the consequences. Ah, who knows? Maybe you sealed the breach. The Chantry gets off its ass and all those soldiers go home and get fat.
You think?
It could happen. It won't. But it could.
Well, that's a little sobering. But yeah, I guess if it comes down to who makes the tough decisions, that would make me the leader at this point. I'm certainly the one that everyone seems to defer to make every single call.
Nice work at Redcliffe. I could help the mages learn to work with Inquisition soldiers if you like. Not that the chief has any apostates in the group.
I'd like to know more about the Iron Bull.
The chief. Last time I met him, he saved my life. I never thought I'd work for a Qunari, but he grows on you. He's not like any commander I've ever worked for. That's for damn sure.
How's Iron Bull as a commander?
If you know what you're doing and hold up your end, he's easy. He doesn't accept any less. It keeps us alive, he leads from the front, and if you've an idea that'll win the fight, he listens. I've seen bands whose captains had to prove they were swinging the biggest sword. Well, isn't like that. The charges might give him more lip than you'd expect, but every one of us would lay down our lives for the big ass.
How did a Tevinter soldier wind up in a Qunari spy's mercenary company?
I wasn't a soldier at the time. I was in some trouble, trying to flee Tevinter. A tribune and his men caught me in a border town tavern. They meant to make an example of me. Bull killed them. Gave up his eye doing it. Patched me up and asked if I was looking for work. I've been putting up with his jokes ever since.
That's how he lost the eye.
Yes. The guards had me on the tavern floor when Bull came inside and yelled for them to stop. One of them saw trouble coming and figured he'd finish me off. The guard had a flare. Bull put himself between me and the blow. The gaunt idiot. Didn't even know me.
Is it strange to work for Qunari?
He hasn't tried to convert us to the Qun, if that's what you're asking. The Bull's charges don't care who you light a candle for, so long as your shield stays up. If he hadn't told me he was Ben Hasroth, I'd have thought he'd left that life behind.
I didn't expect he'd tell you all that he was a spy.
Not the whole band, but those who've been around long enough to trust. He figures most of us would find out sooner or later, and it should come from him. Eyes to eye, he says. It's never messed up a job. He just writes letters back home. Lots of the boys write letters back home.
We'll talk later.
Okay, so the Iron Bull just sort of seems to be up front with people on a regular basis about the fact that he's a spy for the Qunari, which is an interesting decision to make, because you'd figure, like, he must not be a very good spy if he's just casually telling everyone that he's a spy. Well, I mean, not casually, it's people he trusts, but still, volunteering that information so often because he thinks that, oh, it'll just get out anyway. It's kind of a dangerous precedent if he's told multiple members of the Chargers and myself, just one by one, because he's like, it'll get out eventually. I needed time to quickly edit and upload that last video.
Master Dennett's horses are a fine addition to our stables. I will see they are well tended.
Hey, a little bit of acknowledgement about that hat working out. Alrighty, so Gather Corn gave us 98 gold. And Secrets of Madrasta gave us 44 gold. Okay. Now to the actual quest that I'll send. Oh! Still a half an hour left. Wow, that's a very... You guys are getting a very specific window in how long it takes to render and upload a video. Well, not upload, it's uploading right now, but... That's the time it took me to process and upload and process and render the video, and now I'm at, including the time it took to record the previous episode and how much time's edited out. You know, it's been almost exactly 2.5 hours since I sent her on that mission. I think I saw something new over here. Choose successor in Lides. Part of a Ben Hasrath report noting the current fight for succession in Lides, which has been without direct ruler since Duke Ramash died early in their Elysian Civil War. The duchy will go to one of the three members of the dead Duke's family, all of whom have possible claims to the position due to the complex nature of Elysian politics. His cousin Carolina, already a duchess by marriage, his daughter Monette, whose claim is muddied by her youthful naivete and the fact that her father pushed her into a life of service to the Chantry after his wife's death, likely to protect her from the dangers of the game, and his brother Jean Gaspard, an ambitious and cunning man who has been searching for power. Caroline is capable and not overly invested in overseeing Lides personally. Monette would be the most easily manipulated but less likely to be useful. Jean Gaspard would likely be difficult to manipulate and could present a threat if he succeeds his brother. Any of the three candidates could become a valuable ally in the Inquisition, but the other two must be removed from the play first. Jesus, how are you planning on removing them from play? That's a little concerning. And does kind of sound like a Leliana job. Let's see. So Josephine's on a mission right now, but if she was here, she says that she could destroy Carolina's marriage with four words and proper glove left of the proper table. Wow. Josephine has some issues. And she's disgustingly efficient at this. Okay. Couldn't Carolina be useful, though? Do we need to get rid of her? Okay, Leliana. Monette would do better in the Chantry than in the game. I can see that she is encouraged to take vows. Hey, that's not a bad idea. And you're someone who does that, too. Colin. Jean Gaspard is a cavalier and capable military leader. If we want him removed, I dare say we might recruit him for ourselves. Oh, that's a great idea. If he's a capable military leader and is the one person we specifically don't want leading because the other ones are problematic, getting him to join our group would actually be really good for the Inquisition. I'm going to go ahead and send Colin. Good job. You have good ideas, Colin. I like the way that you think. And now, back to the Storm Coast. Alrighty, so welcome back to the Storm Coast, and at the Hesarian camp where we left off, we're gonna go head to the rift here on the coast, because it's always good to close some rifts. Go get back to this one at some point later, but my first goal is gonna be this one right here, because I'm gonna be on my way to establishing our next camp. And I'm basically just gonna lead a campaign straight across the entire Storm Coast to get all three of these camps established. And I'll probably stop at this camp for a little while to do these nearby warden-related quests, and see how that goes. Let's see, especially since we want to get some artifacts for Blackwall. Speaking of Blackwall, went ahead and brought him along. Hello, there we go. He's in my screen now. And now he's back off my screen, whatever. So I have Blackwall, Solas, and Dorian, because I like the two mage thing a lot. I like having two people that can cast Barrier. That's fun to have. Blackwall's a good offensive caster. Solas is pretty much a mandatory part of my party for this playthrough, it seems, because he's so handy as a defensive spellcaster. And, Blackwall is here because he's just a much more effective tank. I like that. We had two two-handed warriors earlier, and frankly, I wasn't happy with their. Oh my god, dragon! Is that dragon fighting a giant? What the fuck? Can I look at that? That's happening, right? What the fuck? There's a dragon fighting a giant. What's over here? There's just some hounds? Mercenaries, how do you just sort of hang out with that on your horizon? Like it's not happening. How do you ignore that? What the fuck? Can I get a better look at that? I don't want to fight, guys. Don't aggro on me. I'm just trying to look at this fight. Can I, like, zoom in? I think I can, like, zoom in and watch, right? Let's watch. Ooh. Who's gonna win? Probably the dragon, right? Otherwise, what the fuck? That dumb giant's pounding the floor. He's not even attacking the dragon directly. What worries me is whether or not that dragon's going to come and attack me when this is over. Oh, Archer, don't walk over there. What are you doing? They're gonna notice you. You make terrible decisions. This is like watching a train wreck. Is he gonna walk right into that? Are they gonna aggro on him? Granted, they're a little preoccupied, perhaps. Oop! Is that the giant? Is the giant going down? Oh no, the giant's still there. Kind of zoomed into the backdrop for me. Oh, did you guys notice me? Oh, we're in combat now. Okay, let's have us a fight. There we go. Let's go destroy this archer right here. And frame it so that the awesome battle's in the backdrop. All right, on the left's going to be my boring fight, and on the right's going to be the awesome dragon fight. I'm not overly concerned about a Hessian archer's ability to fight with a couple dragons. Yeah, good spell, Solas. I'm glad you have that spell now. For people who haven't played this game yet and are planning on getting it, you should probably... Oh, wow, I'm about to hit level 8. You should probably get Dispel, like, immediately. Because Dispel is clearly an effective spell just for so many purposes, especially for dealing with rifts. And I've regretted not having it around for so long. Come on. Ooh. Looks like Blackwell's putting himself in some danger by activating Bodyguard and absorbing damage coming in towards him from other members of the fight. Looks like the hound went down. Sorry, I'm very distracted by the fight that's happening over here on the right. I just want to watch it go down. Is one of them going to win eventually, or they just fight forever? I kind of wonder now. Weird. Oh, did they drop anything? An amethyst? Man, the whole area just shook from it crying out. Oh god, it's jumping around. Is it going to aggro on us? Hey, now I can probably tell what level it is or something, right? I can't. It's flying. How do you highlight a flying enemy? Jesus Christ, it's big, by the way. Wow. Please don't aggro on these enemies, my characters. Oh. Is the dragon leaving? The dragon just left. Huh. Check the camp real quick for anything cool. Nothing cool. Nope. And there's more columnar jointing everywhere, which is always cool to see. I wonder if I can get in range of this guy. I don't want to fight him. I just want to see if I can get information about him. Come on. There we go. He's a... press R3 to... Oh, some enemies have multiple targets. Press R3 to cycle through them. Okay. Oh, you can target multiple parts of him. Let's see. Oh, he's a level 8 giant, and he's an elite. Should I go after him? I'm a little concerned because he might obliterate me, but at the same time, look how low he is. He's at 4,000 hit points out of 14,000 because of his fight with the dragon. I'm going to go for it, guys. I'm just going to fucking commit because this isn't a terrible idea. It's a terrible idea, by the way. Let's just pop a regeneration potion on both of my tanks real quick just so they can be prepared for what's about to happen here. Guys, going in there. Going in for... Oh! Incomplete barrier right there. That was a little awkward. How did... Blackwell, where'd you go? You get stuck, Blackwell? Okay, Vasky, let's back off for a second. Blackwell, are you gonna attack him? I'm waiting for Blackwell to catch up a little bit. Okay. This chain probably won't do anything. Nope. Oh well. Alright, get in there, everybody! I didn't want to charge in immediately with Vasty because Blackwell wasn't keeping up. Let's see. So how's he doing on hit points? Oh, he's already like half dead from where he was earlier, too. Get a little armor generation. Oh my fucking god, he just threw a rock and flattened Dorian. That's a dick move. Everyone else should be a little more hardy, though. And Solas should at some point revive Dorian, right? Unless he gets flattened by a rock right now. Oh! That didn't do too much damage. You're fine. Oh, it's because you already... Wow, he... How, first of all, what are your reflexes like? He healed so fast, I didn't even see his health go down in the first place, aside from the tiny... It looked like it just did a tiny amount of damage. Come on, go down, buddy. Oh, yep, he revived Dorian. Now we just need this guy to get finished off. He's so close, too. Vasti, are you having trouble? If you look at Vasti, he's just running around in circles and not attacking. Come on, hit him with a thing. I recommend smacking him in the face with things. All right, we won. Yeah, level 8. Vasti leveled up. He's bouncing. He started ragdoll bouncing. All right, level 8. Awesome. Maybe I'll teach my character that awesome ground smashing attack that the bull had. Let's see, what am I doing right now on skills? And no, not one-handed. No, I still have a way to go. I still have to learn clear a path. Still, though, hitting multiple targets with a single swing with your weapon causes stamina for each extra target to regenerate. So 10% stamina regen. Not a bad modifier, really. Oh, he still doesn't have the bonus armor on call to arms. That's, I have a real tank with me, though. I really want to unlock Earth Shattering Strike because that was a cool ability to have around. So fuck it. We're committing. We're committing to my terrible, terrible decisions that I make. Oh yeah, I can re-enable Charging Bull, which is a cool skill to have, but I disabled it because he was tanking, basically, for the party. You want to make sure your tank doesn't have that enabled. Yep, you want Charging Bull disabled if they have it, just because that character's going to... He's supposed to be tanking, and he's going to just go charging off into the distance. How are we doing on potions now? 3 out of 8. So, we're down to 3 out of 8 potions, even though we're, like, a couple feet out of the camp. Oh, wait, the rift is right there. Yeah, fuck it. Let's commit. I'm just going to go for the rift. I was about to backtrack for potions off screen, but if the rift's right here and it's the next thing we do, I think I can take it, maybe, unless we find out the hard way it's like level 12. So much columnar jointing. Yay. I am overly geeking out about this distinct geologic pattern being in the environment. The funny thing is a lot of the geology in this game probably doesn't make sense, because it usually doesn't make very much sense in games. All right, so we have... Yeah, they're level 7. We have 2 lesser shades. 2 wraiths. Is there someone up here on the slope? No. So we have 3 wraiths. There's one off in the distance over there. And we have a lesser terror. No. I don't want lesser terrors. They're irritating. Okay. Well, our best chance is to focus fire, right? That lesser terror is about to come charging in anyway. Come on. Okay. Definitely do a shout. Yeah, they're both doing shouts now for bonus armor. Wow, by the way, look at Blackwall's armor. He has a full health bar of armor stacked up on top. That is nice to have. See, I can do a whirlwind attack. That'd be nice, because they're all around. I'm surrounded by enemies right now. And I think I used a whirlwind, and then I fully regenerated all of my stamina because of my 10% stamina per bonus enemy hit, I think. So I just used a whirlwind, but it looks like I never used anything. All right, he's in. He's here. This lesser terror needs to go down immediately now that it's in the area. Cannot be allowed to proceed the way that he usually does, because that guy is just always a pain. Oh, God. Let's make sure Vasti doesn't go down right now. Okay. Holy fuck. These wraiths are no joke, are they? They just keep wailing on you. That's a problem. Ha. Huh. Can anyone bubble Vasti? Because he's about to go down. Ooh. There we go. That's handy. Please bubble him. There we go. All right, successful bubble. Let's focus on getting this goddamn terror down before Vasti's bubble wears off and he gets freaking obliterated. Quick, go after him. Oh, Vasti's about to go down anyway. Do I let him go down or do I use my last potion? I'm gonna go for it. This is terrible, though. This is a dangerous enough rift that I would have been way better off having a full set of potions and instead of going straight here after the encounter with the giant. Guess the giant went down, though. Oh! And despite healing, Vasti is dead already. Oh, maybe he never got the chance to heal. Blackwall? What? How'd you end up all the way over here? Where were you, Blackwall? I did not notice you run off in this direction. I don't know what he was doing exactly. But Vasti's getting auto-resurrected. There we go. So we can now use his healing potion. It's good to give it to him over Dorian, because he's actually can take more hits in general. And Dorian's down. A little bit of a bummer. Okay, 2 people are down. Someone's right next to me, right? Okay, let's see if I can bring Dorian back up before this gets bad. No. Alright. Alrighty. Abort. Abort.
so much abort, 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 abort. Okay, self-bubble. I self-bubbled. Huh. So that was not ideal. You know what? That seems like a sufficiently dangerous rift, and since I think rifts actually respawn, unfortunately, when you leave them too, so... Yeah, I'm gonna go get my potions back. I'll be back in a little while. That, They do sufficient damage that I'm gonna need some actual healing. Alright, so I'm here, and it's wave two again. Things are not going necessarily amazingly this time either, but I have, Vasti, hopefully reviving Dorian, or he's just gonna stand there like a jackass. But I'm definitely going to need to cast Dispel as fast as possible. Come on. And there went two enemy summons, so now we're just gonna have one, two, three, four incoming enemies, I believe? So hopefully that'll help make this next wave more manageable. I'm gonna have to manually control Vasti to get him to actually get Dorian up, because he's just gonna stand there like a jackass. I don't know what it is about- okay, who's left now? So we have a Lesser Shade. Oh no, Lesser Terror. Oh god. So I specifically got rid of- I think I specifically got rid of the two Wraiths, which, you know, not bad. It's better to get rid of Wraiths than Shades. Shades are like the shittiest of all the enemies, I think, out of these groups, but... The fact that I didn't get a single one of the terrors, because you kind of have to guess who you're getting rid of, is kind of a bummer. I might be in trouble here. So, let's get Blackwall to do his challenge, as he wants to. Immediately chug a regeneration potion. My best chance is just to keep people healing over time, if they're going to survive. And hopefully we can get things to work out. Alright, let's definitely have you bubble. These guys are all nicely in a group together, so let's make you bubble them. So now everyone's bubbled. Shit, we can't really target the shades. We can't really target the lesser guys, the terrors, because they're just gonna be wherever they want. Is one of them spawning right? No, that's just random portal energy. So let's have Dorian hang out here, and, Solos hang out back here. The point being that I don't want my two mages to be in the AoE range of these guys when they come up from underground. I can't control them completely though, so they could show up anywhere. So otherwise, my best option is I just need to target the Shade, because he's the one character that can't just come and go as he pleases. Alright, here we go. I'm fucked, right? Like, this is it. How do you get out of the situation? There's three of them, and they're all gonna AoE at once. I don't know if I'm even physically capable of leaving the zone fast enough, to be honest. I guess I could charge out, maybe? My best chance is just to have, two characters go charging. Maybe they'll escape the AoE before it wipes completely out. Hey! That more or less seemed to work. Unfortunately, the shades can just continue to do that every 5 seconds, so... I can only do that every now and then. What's this green shit right here? I thought all the terrors are still here. Oh well. That's my very temporary solution for that problem. Are any of these terrors hurt at all? One of them came out of the ground over here, didn't he? They look so much like xenomorphs, too. Okay. I guess I just... No, I can't reasonably get over... I don't even know who to target. None of them are hurt, really. It's an all-around bad situation. I need one of these terrors to go down as fast as possible. I may be incapacitated by doing a mighty blow and knocking on his ass. You should probably shout, because there's enemies around. Solos is pretty much fine where he is, and he's ready to revive someone when things go wrong. Dorian... Oh, first of all, really quick, I'm gonna go back to Solos's character screen. I'm gonna re-enable Dispel. If you have any reason to use Dispel, go ahead and do it. I just need to have it disabled so I can manually deal with the problem of him. Shit. Should I use Dorian? Go ahead and use a healing potion, I guess. And then just get the fuck out of that immediate area. I think my best chance is if I can get away with Vasti for a second, I can disrupt the rift. No. I don't know if getting away with Vasti for a second is even a physical yeah. Jesus Christ, what do you do? I can't even move. They just keep knocking me over. There's three of them, too. That's a fuck situation. He's on Dorian, of course. I'm really baffled about lesser terrors. I don't know what to do. Whenever they show up, I'm like, I guess I'll fight them and maybe they'll die. Or I'll completely get obliterated and that's the end of my entire playthrough. I don't fucking know. They just knock you over and over again and they AoE infinitely.
And then they just do it again. Like, they never stand still for 2 seconds to even get fight. Like, they're an enemy you can't directly fight at any point because they just do whatever the fuck they want. They don't even have to move manually. Come on, try to heal. Yeah, that's my last healing potion. Come on, just do a lot of damage to him really fast. Please. Oh, you have a mine, right? Let's make a mess right here in the middle. Can you do that? Can you do that for me? Can you make a mess over there, buddy? You didn't do it, did you? You probably got knocked over or something. Yes, AoE fire. Just cause mayhem over there. Do you have any skills? I can do a war cry. That'll probably get you some more armor. Both of you guys use war cries. Let's see. You're standing by with a res, so you can res them. You can almost bubble in a second here. I just want to keep making a mess over here to deal with the fact that there's so many enemies clustered there. My best chance, I think, is just to have my ranged. So that was the revive, right? Yeah, that was the revive. So he'll be ready to bubble in a second, though. I'm just trying to. I can't do. Like, my melee characters are useless against the terrors. All they can do is just take the hits. So I'm trying to use Dorian to keep AoEing the area, and that'll hopefully cause damage. And it seems to kind of be working, maybe. That guy's dead. Oh, he's a lesser shade, though. Oh, one of the terrors is about to go down. Just having one down would already be helpful. All right, I'm going to be ready to bubble these guys in a second here. Oh, you don't have the mana, do you? And I can't even do anything to regenerate mana. Ah, shit. Just going to have to commit. All right. You guys roar cry as soon as you can. That's the only chance of getting more health out of this. Otherwise, I don't know what I'm going to do if everyone goes down in a second here, which is what's likely going to happen. Yes, massive explosion. Was that me getting my fire attack off, I think? Just fucking do that more, I don't care. Do as many fire attacks as you can. Make a mess over there. Please make a mess. Did he do it? And then now bubble them. Bubble them quickly before you go down. Yes, you got the bubble off. Good job, Dorian. I can't believe you're still alive over there. Oh, they're not aggroed on you. Oh, thank goodness. Blackwall aggroed the guy off of Dorian. That's why he's alive long enough to cast all these crazy attacks. Ooh. And you're going to be ready to bubble in a moment, too. So I'm just going to keep an eye on... how many enemies are left? 1,800? That's the only one I can see? The other ones must be underground. Are they about to come bursting out of the ground? Or is that genuinely the only guy left? Because I'm not against the idea of him, everyone else being dead. Let's do a charging bull just to generate guard, because that's my best chance at survival at this point. Jesus Christ. Just generate guard to keep these guys going. And it looks like... Oh! Solas, no! Don't cast barrier. Did you already cast it? Oh, he already casted it. Damn it! I was going to use barrier the moment that his health went down, but oh well. Everyone attack this asshole. Did we win? I think we won. Wow, we actually made it. I think I might have figured out a strategy for those assholes. Okay. So even though this was the exact attempt where I'm like, it's impossible to fight these guys, what do you do? I actually have a tip for you guys. I think I came up with a strategy here. Have your tank characters group up and hopefully taunt the shit out of them. Use war cry and taunt and whatever you have at your disposal to make the lesser terrorist target you. Then once they're grouped up on you, have a mage cast AoE spells in the area to completely wipe them out all at once. It's really your only chance. You have to handle it as a team, I guess. Because if you try to take them on directly with just your tank, like, your tanks can't fight. They can't. They're getting knocked over constantly, though. They come out of the ground and knock everyone on their ass, then they AoE like crazy. And wow, the bull charge thing is good for getting out of the AoE, but ultimately, you can't really fight them as a melee character. But wow, grouping them up and just casting a bunch of crazy fire spells. I used Immolate, and I think I used like the mine type ability. I don't know if it's called like Fire Mine or something. But that actually made very quick work to the point where I didn't even notice that two of them died in all the chaos. So that worked out relatively well. Definitely spread out your mages so that even if they do get attacked, well, hopefully you have those spells selected for them that make them less likely to get attacked in general. But if they do get attacked, hopefully they're spread out so they don't get both AoE'd. So that'll at least reduce the damage to your party as a whole. That's done, though. And holy crap, there's a lot of spindleweed here. But anyway, I'm out of potions, so I'm going to go back to camp again to get them all back. And then we'll finally start heading towards that next camp. So I'll see you guys in a little while. That was tough.
Been a long time since I was at sea.
Can we get away from the water? I'm feeling seasick already.
And Dragon Age just crashed. That's a bummer.
Word of what happened in Redcliffe had better not spread.
Oh? Why not?
You think mages will be better off if people know they can change the future?
Ignoring that that's not the case, I suspect people will use any excuse to hate us.
Then you should not give them more.
Did everyone act like this when the sword was invented? Oh, my blushing butt cheeks. Round up everyone who can use these pointy things and lock them away.
It is not the same thing, and you know it.
All right, so we're right back to where we left off with the rift and everything earlier, and we have a weird question mark hanging out over here that I think I'm going to investigate on my way to our ultimate goal, which is to establish a southern camp so I don't have to go such a long distance to get to my quests, because, yeah, I mean, that looks like a great location for a camp, really. But what does that question mark indicate is what I wonder, and I don't know if I can access it from down here or if I need to go up top and try to jump towards it from there. Is there any sort of staircase pattern? Ooh, that looks exactly like what I'm looking for. Any ore around? Keep an eye out for ore, but otherwise, let's go for a little jump. This is not awkward looking at all. There we go. What are we gonna find up here? Ooh, there's my marker. Is that cave what we're looking? Oh, it's a landmark. I can see the diamond shape of a landmark on my mini map. Question is, will I be able to make it up this drainage or not? Because it's getting pretty steep. Damn you, drainages! I can kind of go around here, right? Follow the staircase pattern to circumvent the ledge.
Yeah, this is working out just fine. There we go.
Oh, spooky cave has enemies in it. Let's not investigate that quite yet. Instead, let's just claim this landmark.
Yeah.
Morin Steps. It is not uncommon to enter a cave nestled in the basalt columns of the Storm Coast and discover traces of ancient dwarven architecture. Prior to the First Age, the dwarven people maintained a sizable presence on the coast. Mining guilds were drawn to the area's then plentiful mineral deposits. All dwarven activity ceased when darkspawn incursions forced the deep roads to be sealed, severing the region from Orzammar. From the Storm Coast and its History by Brother Vincent, Chantry Scholar. So is that a dwarven cave over there then? I might have to take a detour and check that out. Mainly because I might forget that this place exists if I wander off too much. What's this cave called? Does it have a name? When you highlight other things, they have names. But this one doesn't seem to have anything showing up for it. Oh well. Let's take a cautious look inside. Am I even going to be able to see if I go in here? Oh, it's kind of lighting up. What's in here? Oh, no. Those are giant spiders. And a deep stalker? Hey, that's the thing that they wanted me to kill to make the thing, to make the, I can't see shit in here, by the way. That's not just the render. You guys going to come up here? Uh-oh. Party, get over here. Could release you guys in here. Oh, gross! No! Get it away! Giant gross-ass spider? Guys, get up here. God damn it. Okay, if I run over here for a little while, will they teleport up? Let's try that. I need my party to be adjacent to me if I'm going to fight. Come on. Anyone around here to aggro? So far, I don't think so. I don't want a surprise fight. There we go, they're here. Ooh, they're attacking. Who are you attacking? Oh, the spider's down there. Let's go wreck some Actually, I don't even need to go down there. I could just hang out up here and you guys could shoot him from here. Right? That'll work. Oh well, let's get in there. Alright, fucking bull charge, motherfucker! Knock him on his ass. I don't think that actually worked out very well for me. Oh well. Oh, he's level 8. Let's be careful about this. Is everyone in here level 8? Because a lot of my characters are not level 8. Be cautious, but I think we outnumber them, unless there's going to be more surprise enemies in there. Alright. Party, you here? They're all here now. Okay. Thought they were gonna get stuck outside or something. So how many enemies are around here? Is it just the one spider and the one deep stalker left? I can't see shit in here, by the way. That's not ideal. I could use some glowy bits in here. Hello, friend. You don't look fucking disturbing at all. What is that down there? It's a glowy thingy. Uh-oh. Those are like three deep stalkers. And down there is something else? This might be a bad place to navigate, especially since it's dark in here. Maybe I shouldn't be doing this, or maybe I should fucking destroy this guy. I'm gonna regret this, aren't I? Oh, God. Yeah, no, I'm not doing this. I'm not doing this. We're aborting this mission. We're all aborting this mission. Disengage. Disengage. I'm glad that they don't seem to automatically return to combat. That's nice. I was worried that they would ignore me and go back to Oh, well, this guy's still here. If he's gonna come out here, then he's gonna fucking die outside. You a dumb little boy. Bet you feel silly now, huh? I can't get to you because I'm stuck on top of my mages, but if I could get to you, you'd be in serious trouble right now. I can't. Vasti, you having that much trouble with pathfinding right now? Okay, he's dead. We got it anyway. Vasti, you silly, silly child. Hey, Deepstalker Hide, Codex Entry unlocked, and I can use that hide with some elf root to create some power. Because I did it for the power. But let's get to that camp already. Before I run into a more secret caves full of level 8 monsters. It's not necessarily just the level 8 in this, too. I'm going to avoid going in there just because I can't see right now. I need one of those awesome torches from before. But last time, the torch was right at the entrance to the cave. This time, there's just no sign of one. Does that cave... Wow, that cave seems to go all the way through here, too. That must be the other end of it on the map over there. What's up there? That's all glowy. Is that red lyrium? Some sort of freaky... it is like a dwarven tower of some kind. Could be red lyrium. That'd be bad. Varric might want to see this sometime. Oh, wow. This is a crazy sight right here. Look at those crazy columnar joint columns. They are columns that consist of columnar jointing, but I can't just call it columnar jointing. They're also columns of it, because they're clearly in giant column shapes. careful. Let's not break any ankles here. That'd be really embarrassing. Way for the Inquisition to end. I'm not taking any paths today, am I? I'm just sort of taking weird directions instead. Please don't fall on your ass. Careful.
Search the area.
Hey, we made it. More or less. Should be a camp, like, right over here. What does this thing signify? Anything? Just kind of random runes that are there for me to notice, but not really do anything about? Welcome to the small grove. Oh, there's the camp! Any bad guys around? I don't see any red marks yet. Yeah! A new camp means a new checkpoint that I can safely get potions from without having to navigate the environment first.